Or that was actually magenta. I'm a fool.
Hey cutie, in today's video we're going to be opening the July Paletteful Packs. So if you want to see what is inside this box and what we end up making, make sure to watch through the whole video. Maybe go ahead and give me a like and subscribe, and I hope whatever's in here is a fun time. So we're going to take our trusty cat knife and bust right into this thing. Let's see. Ooh, blue worms this time. Oh, and a cute sticker. Let's see. That's a little notebook or sketchbook. Stick that here. Alrighty. Okay. So, Ecoline hand lettering brush pens in a variety of colors. This is a 10 pack. Especially for hand lettering, it looks like. Alright, cool. We'll check these out. Okay, so we've got some more things. We also have a Tombow ABT water-based 493, looks like brush and felt tip pen. Yep, we got the brush tip and yeah, felt tip, really small cap on that side, and both the colors 493 and 451, which are two blues. Speaking of blue, we also have a blue Princeton brush, a round tin brush, a little crunchy. So it's round and like pretty fine point too. All right. We have this Seth Cole paper that takes up the whole box, so okay, got it. It's a Seth Cole. Seth Cole watercolor paper, 9x12, 140-pound heavyweight acid-free watercolor 12-sheet pad. All right. Set this box aside. Watercolor paper, a watercolor brush, water-based markers, and are these also water-based? Oh, these are Royal Talons. Okay. Set of 9 brush pens with concentrated transparent watercolor paint and 1 blender. Wow, these are available in 59 colors. So, okay, yeah, this is our blender. It even says blender on it. Alright, let me pull up the Paletteful Pack's email. Alright, so yes, we got the Royal Talons Ecoline Brush Pen 10-piece set. The Summit Ultimate White Synthetic Watercolor Brush. Oh, yeah, Princeton Summit, okay. The Dual Brush Pens. Watercolor paper, and then our prompts are the 1980s, picnic, bird's eye view, and milkshake. I feel like 1980s and milkshake kind of go hand in hand. We'll go ahead and swatch these, but I'm thinking
something like a 1980s style shake shop diner situation could be cool. Let's start with our Tombow dual brush pens. So you can do some fairly fine lines and some thicker ones. This isn't the most flexible brush, so it can't be too, too thick unless you go from an angle. But you can get pretty fine. Let's check out the bullet or felt tip side. Tombow 493. Yeah, it just feels like writing with a felt tip pen. Not bad. We'll do the 451. Sorry if you hear my bracelet hit the desk. I have a little magnet charm on my bracelet, and the edge of the table is metal. It's a nice icy blue color. Get there when we come back and test the brush. For now, I want to go in with these Ecoline pens. These are not organized in rainbow order, so first let me do that because I've just gotta. These are a fairly soft brush. You can also get fine details with them. I don't know much about hand lettering. I think it's something like if you're going down, you make it thick. If you're going to the side, you make it thin. Something like that. A little less robotic looking, but similar. Or that was actually magenta. I'm a fool. These don't smell like watercolor. They have kind of an odor to them, almost like alcohol markers, but not quite as strong. They smell kind of like Sharpies. It's a good neutral gray. It looks like you can get some tonal differences, so that's nice.
do a rainbow test, and we'll use the blender. Okay, let's test my theory that we can use the blender to do a lighter application of one of these very saturated colors. And I dropped one. Let's do the purple since it's quite dark. So what I'm going to do is touch, first get the paper shreds off of this. Okay. I'm going to touch it to the tip of our blender. You might be able to see that it took on the color a bit. It is lighter. It's also sort of lighter on the side that's closer to the marker. I wonder how long it takes to clean off the tip. It's not too bad. I also wonder if we can take, say, our purple, touch it around the edge here. Pink because it's cute on the tip. And have a nice blend coming right out of the marker. Sort of. It is quite pretty. The two-tone doesn't last as long, but that's understandable. Last test, let's get some water, and for starters, just run the brush across things, and then we'll try some other stuff too. Also, let me try writing on top of these with our Tombow. Yeah, works well enough. Yeah. What about the lighter color? Still works. It does get on the brush tip a little bit. Because we can do this with the blender, I bet we can do it on the other marker nibs too. Our brush nice and saturated. And let's see. It's just tearing up the paper a bit. Oh, okay. It's picking up the pigment a little bit. So what if we take a
applies a bit like watercolor. Interesting. Is the brush affected? Nope. That's nice. One last test. Let me just scribble in the palette. Seems to work pretty well, and I'll do that with a Tombow pen as well. Which doesn't work as well, and is squeaky because the brush is a bit harder. So this is another option if we want to apply a thinner, less saturated layer, or if we want to smudge what we have underneath. Just pick all this up. Okay. And then Tombow is a cleaner color, honestly. Okay, cool. I think that's a good little experiment. Okay, I like this vibe that I found. It looks like there's a lot of like funky shapes and patterns going on. Let's say this is our paper. I'm gonna do like some signage. That's the idea I'm going for. So there's a lot of these kind of shapes. Where they go out and then go back in. So we'll do that. And then there's often something big here that says hamburgers. Restaurant name here, and like a funky shape. And everything seems to be capitalized. So, something I have learned about lettering is you want to plan out your spacing based on how many letters you have. So, one of the ways to do that is to find your center letter. So, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, our center point is right here. So our center of the sign is roughly here.
So then we want to fit 5 letters here and 5 letters here. So 1, 2, 3, 5. Make sure that looks evenly spaced, which it looks okay to me. I think this could scoop a little bit. And then same thing with our milkshakes. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Same thing. Center is like right here. Because we found out this is a little bit too much to the right. So 5 and 5. You can also find your centers here. Vanilla, strawberry, chocolate down here, but we'll get there in a second. And then this is 5 letters, so our T is the middle. So our middle is like here, so that's where we want our T to go. And then we have 1, 2, 1, 2, and that'll help us determine the size. I also want to include and fries. So whenever you're planning out lettering, the space counts. So it'd be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And so our F is our center point. So our F will go here. And then I have 4 on either side, so 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, except these are gonna go down here, sorry. Thank you.
I'm I
This box. I did find out water-based markers are not my favorite. I did get a little frustrated during this, but it's okay. It's okay. It still came out all right. I ended up also using some Poscas and some colored pencils, as you saw in the video, but I still think it's pretty neat. Pretty neat. I think it definitely gives off the like 80s diner vibes that I was looking for. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Check out my other socials down in the description. And most of all, don't forget to stay charming. Goodbye.